idea of the Freedom Rides is a really radical idea. The idea of going into Mississippi and going into Alabama and challenging segregation so frontally and so aggressively in many ways is something that alarmed not only those who oppose civil rights, but those within the civil rights community.
The first 2 days of the ride was uneventful. If we could do this all the way through, then we will have achieved what we had set out to do.
There were two buses leaving Atlanta for Birmingham that Mother's Day morning. One Greyhound, one Trailways. So two groups of Freedom Riders. They left an hour apart. Only one made it all the way to Birmingham. The Anniston clan had it all worked out.
There was a flash fire on the bus.
Pretty soon, the whole back of the bus was black. You couldn't even see in front of your face.
People were gagging, and they were crawling around on the ground. They were trying to get the smoke out of their chest. It was just an awful, 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 awful scene.
The people on the Trailways bus going into Birmingham don't know that the Greyhound bus has been burned in Anniston, outside Anniston. Now they're going into a city which is the worst city for race in the whole United States.
The Birmingham Police Department, headed up by Bull Connor, had made an agreement with the head of the Klan to give them time to beat up the Freedom Riders at the Trailways bus station.
Why are you planning to keep up this ride?
We're planning to keep it up because we feel that we must not surrender to violence.
At a certain point, the Kennedy administration and the state officials in Alabama make a decision to do what they could have done in the first place, and that is provide the protection necessary to make sure that the Freedom Riders get to the border of Alabama and Mississippi safely.
We escorted them all the way with state troopers and National Guardsmen all the way to the Mississippi line.
The arrangement is made between the federal government, Robert Kennedy, and the most powerful man in Mississippi, James O. Eastland, the senator. In exchange for providing safety for the Freedom Riders, their civil rights can be violated and they can be arrested in Jackson peacefully and calmly under laws which have twice been invalidated by the U.S. Supreme Court.
Our law enforcement officers did, in fact, enforce these laws, and they will continue, ladies and gentlemen, to enforce all of the laws of the state of Mississippi.
Ross Barnett wants to teach them a lesson. And the lesson is, I'm going to send you to a real prison, to Parchment Penitentiary. So you're going to do hard time in Mississippi. You're not going to, this is not going to be a city jail. This is going to be like the reputation of the Old South, where people did work gangs.
The Freedom Riders take the pretty brave stand of saying, fine, we'll go to Parchment, and we'll fill Parchment up, and we'll make Parchment the next site of the civil rights movement.
We must now fill the jail and be willing to remain for at least a minimum of 60 days or more.
It became a continuation of the Freedom Ride. Parchment becomes every much a location in the Freedom Rides as the bus depots themselves. They intensify the whole project, and they have people coming in from all across the country to participate. And they're coming in by plane, and they're coming in by bus, and they're coming in by train.
I want to help break down this barrier of segregation.
How about you? Can you give me any of your feelings on why you want to take part in this?
Well, I want to help establish the right of all Americans to eat together and to travel together.
Why do you think it's your responsibility?
I think it's every American's responsibility. I only think that some are more conscious of their responsibility than others.
As the Freedom Rider leaders called for more Freedom Rides going into Mississippi, Bobby Kennedy decided to go formally to the Interstate Commerce Commission, the ICC, and to ask them for a sweeping desegregation order. As Attorney General, Bobby Kennedy didn't have the power to take down the Jim Crow signs. Only the ICC did.
Now the matter is before the ICC. We have taken action in the government to try to end segregation in all of these facilities.
Eventually, there were over 430 Freedom Riders, 300 of whom ended up at Parchment. They became even more committed. They became the shock troops of the movement.
We had moments there to learn, to teach each other the way of nonviolence, the way of love, the way of peace.
Finally, on September 22nd, after hundreds of arrests, the ICC issued its order. It gave the Freedom Riders what they've been asking for. The colored only, the whites only signs that had been in the bus and rail stations for generations, they finally came down.